こんにちは。
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
I'm now.
Yes. Pleasure to meet you.
みなさんこんにちは。 TV グルーヴの小西奈緒です。本日は新作ソロアルバムオールアメリカンを携え来日したニック・カーターさんにお越しいただきました。 Welcome back to Japan.
Thank you.
今日はインタビューの機会をいただきましてありがとうございます。
Thank you for this time.
話聞かせていただきたいと思います。ではまず最初に、今回は3年ぶりの来日となりましたがいかがですか？
I am back home. I feel so happy to be here becauseI missed it. You know, that's the reason why I made this album, was so that I could come back sooner, and, you know, be able to just walk around here again, and I just love it.
昨日のそのイベントでは、ファンの皆さんと直接握手会を行ったんですけれども、いかがでしたか?
Well, originally it was just supposed to be a handshake, but I wanted to give everyone a hug.
Yes.
So, that's how much I love my fans here, is that they...I need to give them more time.
すごくいいお話聞かせていただきたいんですけども、今回はあの妊娠中の奥様もご一緒されているということなんですが、どこか一緒に行かれたりしましたか？
We went out last night and you know, we went to shabu shabu.
Shabu shabu.
So that was really good. And yeah, we're actually doing a lot of press right now. So we're going to take one extra day after and stay.And then just go everywhere, take the trains and go all over Tokyo. There's maybe an arcade, maybe a big arcade to play some video games. And then we were thinking about going to this Owl Bar or Owl restaurant.
Owl Bar.
I think, that, I don't know what it's called, but they have that, owls there.
コアな場所に行かれるようなんですけれども、今回はなんといっても5年ぶり3作目にあたるソロアルバム「オールアメリカン」を持って来日されたんですけれども、この作品はどういったものかお聞かせください。
Well, this album was made when I first started to write the album. It was just for Japan, only for Japan. So the music was written with the fans in mind.And what they would want, and so it turned out exactly the way that I wanted it to, because I really didn't care necessarily what the outside world wanted, you know, from Nick Carter. I only cared what the Japanese fans would want.
昨日のイベントでもおっしゃってたんですけども、その日本のファンが望むような形のアルバムを作られたっておっしゃってたんですけど、具体的には一体どういうものをイメージしていたんでしょうか?
Well, because the way I see it is that the Japanese people and fans, they're like me in a lot of ways, like very young at heart, and just they just are have good hearts and want to have fun, and you know, and they don't take things too seriously, and I think that's what I wanted the album to sort of reflect, was that it's just stories and fun stuff and fun music that you can play and sing and dance to. So,
実際にイベントでは2曲ほど披露されていて、とても楽しかったんですけれども、中でもリードシングルになっている1999という曲について聞かせていただきたいと思います。
Well, 1999 turned out to be a very special song, because what the story is that I was 19 years old in 1999, and during that time, we were, the Backstreet Boys were on top of the world. We just releasing our album, the biggest album we ever did was called Millennium.
Yes.
And so we released that album, but at the same time, I was a teenager. So I was going through all the things that a teenager was going through during this huge success. So I was having a lot of fun. And so I talk about that in the song. And I was able to really play with the different things that I experienced that were cool during 99. You know, Segas, you know, Reeboks, Tupac and Nirvana, you know, all these different things that are sort of, you know, that I went through and I experienced. And so in a lot of ways you can go back and really see the, you know, live those things、through the song.
あの実際に今お話にあったミレニアムというアルバム、これ実はあの私が一番最初に買ったアルバムだったりするんですけれども、本当にそういう世代のファンにとってはあの曲すごく楽しくて、も本当に当時のことが思い出させる素敵な曲なんですけれども、昨日あのファンの前でパフォーマンスしてみていかがでしたか？
Well, it's cool to, for me to sing those songs because number one, you know, fans that remember like yourself really love to hear those songs and go back in time, sort of like 1999. 、but for me, I get satisfaction singing the song because I'm a little older now, and so I think the way that I sound is better than when I sounded then. So、it's cool for me. I get a lot of satisfaction out of that.
あとあの日本のファンには嬉しい日本語での歌詞、さよならっていう歌詞が入ってるんですけども、これは一体あのどこから湧いてきたんでしょうか？
Well, that's what I talk about. So when we wrote the entire record, not just from the way that it sounded sonically with the music and、the lyrical, you know, content, you know, it was always, we thought, well, whatdo you think the Japanese fans would like to hear? And so I'm like, well, this is a perfect spot in the song to say sayonara. You know, so that's how you know、that it was really written for, the album was prepared for Japan only. And even like, I go one step further,、that's why I got Avril Lavigne involved with the album, because she has such a huge fan base and a big love、for Japan as well, the same way that I do.、So we shared that in common, and I'm like, well, you have to, I really would love you to be on this album with me, you know, so that、because it is made for Japan, and she did that because of that reason.
あの短い一言にこんな意味が込められたっていうのは本当にもうファンにとってはたまらないく嬉しいことだと思います。
Thank you.
ありがとうございます。次にあの同じ作品のミュージックビデオについて聞かせていただきたいんですけども、とってもとっても見てて楽しい作品になっていたんですが、コンセプトはまずどういったものだったんでしょうか？
Yeah, I always had this idea of wanting to perform in just a regular household、like a house, an American house、but perform on a roof、
yes.
and I had this idea like since I was really little、and I was able to kind of, you knowTalked to the director when we were coming up with the idea, and then he just was like, "Let's do it." And so, but it was just about having fun in the music video, and because look, you know, for me, I am a big kid at heart. I just, you know, I still play video games. I still have fun. I don't ever want to grow up, and I'm not gonna, you know, if I don't have to. So I was able to really just do all the things that I really want to do in a music video. And so I wouldn't be judged for it. So I was, and also too, we were able to play with the song content and lyrics and concept to really, it just worked together really great.
AJ さんが Backstreet Boys のピザを配達するというまさかのこう小さな役で付き合ってくれたりだとか、あとあの I want it that way のパロディーシーンなんかも含まれていたんですけど、それも楽しむっていうことから生まれたシーンなんでしょうか？
Absolutely, because that's the thing. I'm not just a normal 19-year-old who, you know, was doing all the things and, you know, the nostalgic things like Segas and playing all these things. I was also in the Backstreet Boys, so it was only fitting to be like, well, this is all of what I was going through and all of who I am. So by doing that, I wanted that way a parody. It was just, and we wanted to just have fun and make people laugh. That was really our goal when we did the music video. Exactly. So I was wearing that and looked to, and every time anybody watches it, they immediately remember that. So which is crazy becauseI'm not doing exactly everything that we did in the music video, but just the white outfit, you know, it just brings back memories.
あの先ほどお話に上がったアブリル・ラビンさんとのコラボ曲「Get Over Me」についても聞かせていただきたいんですけれども、まあ、彼女も日本好きという共通点から生まれたっていうふうにおっしゃってましたが、実際にコラボされてみていかがでしたか？
It was so easy because, well, we became friends on the Backstreet Boys、tour in America because she was...co-headlining with us、and so we became friends there, and、we were just talking. Actually, it was funny, on that tour she had released the Hello Kitty video, yeah. and obviously the Japanese fans and people loved it, and we were watching it as well, and I'm like, so you must really like Japan, right? And she's like, yes, and I'm like, well, I love Japan, and she's like, really? And I'm like, well, I'm doing another album over there for our fans, so would you be interested? And she's like, well, since it's for Japan, absolutely. So, and also there's a lot of similarities in the kind of music that, like, I do as a solo artist, and she does as a solo artist. You know, it's a little different. You know, it's more of a pop rock based type music. So it was just fitting for us to do it together. And so I also felt it was cool too, because like a lot of her Japanese fans, you know, I'm a fan of her fans because they like her type of music, and you know, I do music that's similar to hers as well.
とても相性が良かったっていうことなんですけれども、普段はミクさんグループで活動されていますが、今のようにソロの活動もされているということで、一体どういうところが違うんでしょうか？
Well, the difference is that with the Backstreet Boys, I dance a lot more, you know, on stage. So that's good because it keeps me in shape. And then when I'm on the solo, I kind of play more instruments by myself, and I dance a little bit too. But those are kind of some of the differences. Also, when I'm I write pretty much all of my music. Backstreet Boys, we don't write everything. You know, there's kind of like a little bit of songs that are submitted to us. And then, so that's a little of the differences between, you know, what we do. And, you know, obviously I do a little bit more like a pop rock type stuff. And the Backstreet Boys does more like a R&B, you know, mixture type of music.
今度私生活についてのお話なんですけれども、2014年にご結婚されましたが、そのことによって音楽への変化というのはあったりしたんですか？
Well, yeah, absolutely. There's you know, when you get married and you have someone who you love and someone who kind of you can hide behind and protect one another, you know, there's songs that I have written, like I Will Wait. I obviously wrote that song with, you know, the intention of thinking of being in love with someone, being with them for, you know, till you're older, you know. So if you watch the music video for I Will Wait, it has that as well. And some of the songs I write about my relationship as well. So, but then there's also, you know, songs that I just write that are just crazy songs that have nothing to do with anything. So there's a lot of that on this album as well.
ちょっとロマンチックなお話だったんですけども、近々のお子さんが生まれてお父さんになられるということで、このことによってまた音楽への変化も生まれると思うんですが、まずお子さんにとってどういう父親になっていきたいと思いますか？
I don't know. I'm a little concerned because I don't have it set in my mind, but I think that I would rather just let life flow and see what's going to happen, you know, because I don't want to predetermine, you know, anything. You know, obviously I want to be loving and nurturing and protective and all those things, and honest, you know. So those are kind of the general things that I would like to be, but overall, you know, I just want to be me and just be fun and be a fun dad, I guess.
またじゃあ楽しい音楽が生まれてくることを期待しています。
Thank you.
それでこちらからの生まれてくる赤ちゃんと、あと奥様へのプレゼントとして、ちょっと靴下をご用意させていただきました。
Present for your baby and for your wife.
ありがとうございます。
こちらがパパ大好きって書いてあるんですね。
This is I love dad. That's for the baby.
で、こちらが奥様用なんですけども、かわいい。
かわいい。
And that's for your wife.
かわいい。
はい、受け取ってください。
Please have it.
Thank you.
はい、で、ニックさんにもですね。
They have a present for you too.
ちょっとクールな大人になっていただこうと思いまして。
For you to be a cool.Adult.
Nice.
Samurai sword, かと思いきや実はこれ傘なんです。
You might think it's a sword, but it's an umbrella.
いいね、これでお子さんと遊んでください。
Yes, please play. You can play that. Play with your kid.
Can be perfect.
Perfect.
I'm Nick Carter, and to all the viewers of TV Groove, just want to say Aishimasu, and thank you for supporting me, and I look forward to seeing you soon. I come back on tour.